Step Up 2, The Streets, is the second installment in the Step Up franchise of low-budget, high-energy dance movies. And it's one of those sweet little pictures about a group of plucky youngsters who get together and put on a big show in an abandoned barn. Well, not exactly. But in spite of the hip-hop beats and several acres of exposed midriff, Step Up 2 has more in common with those old Judy Garland, Mickey Rooney movies than you might think.
You should really wait your turn.
Ooh. I couldn't.
I didn't know you could salsa.
There's a lot you don't know about me, Andy.
How would you surprising considering how much you talk about yourself?
Ooh.
Brianna Evigan plays Andy, a tough girl from Baltimore who's part of the 410 crew. Andy betrays the 410, however, when she starts attending the Maryland School of the Arts, where she gathers up a different crew. A whole TV season's worth of drama is shoehorned into this hectic little movie, all of it leading up to a climactic dance battle in the rain with flashlights. The writing is clumsy, the acting is amateurish, and too many of the dance numbers are edited in that frantic style that makes it hard to appreciate what the dancers are actually doing. But I liked what they were doing, and in spite of everything, I was won over by Step Up to the Streets. It's so goofy and earnest and energetic, I just can't bring myself to be a hater.
You're recommending it. On the record.
I'm saying
Step Up. You are following Kevin Smith, loved the original Step Up, and now A.O. Scott of the New York Times is saying, go see Step Up 2.
If you have like 10 or 11-year-old, because this movie is squeaky clean, in spite of some of the bumping and grinding.
It's the kind of movie where the crew members face up and they're like, I'll dance you anytime. You know, nobody's pulling out switchblades. It's not even as threatening as like West Side Story.
There's that one moment where the leader of the 410 crew named Tuck,
tough guy,
beats up the other guy. And he has the greatest line in the movie, which is, somebody clean up that damn fish.
Anyway, before we go any further with this detailed examination of this classic film, I want to say, for the record, I'm not quite recommending it, Tony.
Fair enough.
However, I kind of shared your affection for the film. I'm pretty close to recommending it. I'm saying, for kids, it's completely harmless.
Bring your stuff.
You got to look at this as basically, it's in the tradition, if you will, of Footloose and Flashdance.
Really, it does not take itself seriously.
And these dancers are amazing. Some of these kids are really, really talented. But it is funny because at one point, like one of the DJs says to the kids from the School of the Arts, he goes, this ain't no High School Musical. And I'm like, because High School Musical is actually a little edgier than this.
That's probably true. It deals more directly with real issues.
It's harmless. I actually understand your point of view. I can't quite recommend it, but I think, for a certain demographic, why not? I do like the energy and the spirit here.
Okay.